actually supposed to date back from the Norman period. But I don't know how true it is. We'll go around and have a look. Well, first we'll start off with a war memorial. Obviously not dating back from Norman times, but still interesting. Nevertheless, I don't know whether you can read that at the top. So God loved the world, that. He gave his only begotten Son. World War One. On this side, in any case. It says, rest eternal, grant them, Lord. Light perpetual. Lighten them? Oh, there's a Second World War bit, 1939 to 1945. I always say, lest we forget, if it weren't for these people that died in World War One and World War Two, where would we be? We're obviously now heading up towards the church. Wayside preaching cross. Stone base steps predate the church and are probably Saxon. Well, goes back as far as that? That's crazy. Interesting. And we'll see if anything sticks out and we shall video it. 1783. Smell barbecue, it's making me hungry. I wonder where the actual oldest grave marker is. Quite a big graveyard. There for 1899 on the floor. Actually, don't fancy if it's recording. I've got to get one of them flip screen cameras eventually. I'm sure there's a, well, it's Sunday today, so there's going to be a service later on. I think the morning service is done now, so hopefully it won't be a problem going into the church. Sitting on that top of that grey thing. I don't know what sort of pigeon it is. Yeah. Sorry I'm whispering, I just seem to be a bit more need to be feel as if I need to be a bit respectful. So that's why my voice is probably a bit low. Hopefully you'll still be able to hear me. I don't know why I whistle when I come to graveyards, just respectful I suppose. It's a place of peace and quiet contemplation. Obviously then. Modern part of the graveyard. Oh, now I'm going to sit. Now I'm going to sit on this bench and respect the peace for 5 minutes. Oh. Again. I've had me 5 minutes. You always come to these places and they always seem so peaceful. Or I don't know, is it just me? Obviously where they look after everything. There. Gothic looking gravestones. Oh, my voice is going to be too low. I'm going to have to switch the video in a minute because I'm coming up to people. People that I have had a need to respect their privacy and perhaps they don't want to be on YouTube. We've got no finger today. I think I've remembered to realise that it's no good there. Hopefully. Now I'm going to go in the crypt. Hopefully I'll be able to find out some information on the church. Maybe find out what the oldest grave marker is. Oh, you nearly had the finger again until I realised. Oh my God. Eighteen seventy or 1824. There's 100 years difference in between this one and this one. Nobody will be able to. I've got to take a photo of some of these stained glass windows. They're absolutely gorgeous. Well, according to this. Crypt is down this way. I think I'm going to turn the light on. Oh, that's better. Oh dear, perhaps there is no light. Oh, that's not good. I think on this occasion I'll make my own mind. I don't know why the lights haven't come on. Matter is there no lines. I don't know why there's no lights come on. Perhaps it's shut. Perhaps I ain't even supposed to be down here. I don't know. I don't even know whether you'll be able to see that. It's a gorgeous picture. Candles dotted all over the place. Wilmot. Obviously the lords of the mansion, or lords of the land. I'm a bit disappointed that the lights didn't work. Always come prepared. Oh, that's a ripe old age. Just need to point out the architecture of this place. Lovely dome ceiling. Sandstone and even some painting. I wonder what them paintings were supposed to look like. Have they been whitewashed over with the original? There's something up above the window. But I can't make it out, can't read it. I'm going to go back here and take some stills. I'm not even sure what this is. The Crypt was used in the 18th and 19th centuries as a family burying vault for the lords of the manor. A window into the south aisle was enlarged to allow coffins to be passed through, and two 13th century stone coffins were used as a lintel. One may be seen leaning against the west wall of the crypt. In 1900, the body were reinterred beneath the slab of the floor, which was laid at the same time. And in 1948, the cairn stone cone, which had Verdo stood in the circle, was set up in the crypt to save it from destruction. Well, you see these little stone seats here at the side of the wall? Rise to the expression. I think it's the weakest to the wall, because this is where the elderly and youngsters used to sit. That's a stone coffin lid. This is engraved. Impressive. Looking at a little cranny. Well, I'm guessing that's near about done there. Apparently these, which we've just had a look at, are the original entrances to the crypt, I believe. And they're up the side of the wall somewhere, which I'm going to go and have a look at. This is impressive. The front is impressive. Damn. Okay, let's do that again, shall we? Now the lights are on in the crypt. I don't know. Might have been weird. and I didn't record it. So I'm going to have to do it again. I don't know what that is. I don't know why them paintings up above the altar. I don't know why they haven't been restored. I would have thought they should have been restored. Hey, it's a grade one listed building, this is. So perhaps you've restricted on exactly what you can do in these sort of places. Well, we sound so echoey in here.
This is the end of my visit to St John the Baptist Church in Berkswell. I thought it dated back from Normandy times, but apparently it dates back even earlier to Saxon times. Thanks for watching, guys and girls. I'll talk to you soon.